Can we just take a moment and think about the time my dad accidentally made a fried egg that looks exactly like Africa?
I'm actually the most impressed by the fact the egg also has a Madagascar. Madagascar.
Trying to deny that you might actually like a certain character.
It's total fabrication. Pure fiction. Not a chance. Wrong.
No. No way. It never happened.
It totally did.
Whoa. Leg day, bro.
You're an embarrassment to this whole gym.
It looks like a potato of four toothpicks. Slicing my ham.
Death is on its way, human.
Could I cuddle death and give death chin scritches and kisses?
Scritches cannot postpone the inescapable fate ordained to you, human. However, they may earn you purrs and love rubs.
Someone reading my writing.
Wow, that's a great story.
Me sticking my hands in the plot holes.
Thanks, it has pockets.
Yo, you emo bitches okay?
I'm fine, thank you for asking. Though recently,
there has been a darkness growing within me. I just learned that a Japanese term for seahorse is Tatsuno Otoshigo, and it literally means dragon's illegitimate child.
Look at him. He's a bastard.
Whoa, who do we fight? Anyone not wearing a primary color? This is my favorite line in the show.
Oh my god, my tears.
The three stages of a cat yawn.
The tiny little owl mouth. The sticky the tongue out real far.
An entire face plays open like a little crappy horror. Revealing it in those data points and the lights all died.
And stage 5. Blame. Love writing stories and making a half slice of life plot, half important plot stuff thing.
1 minute it's like, ah, the main character's crushed on a girl and doesn't know how to tell her.
Then the next is like, hey bruh, you know what would be pretty cool? If we killed God.
Ah yes, the four horsemen of the apocalypse. I think you mean, oh yes, the four human emotions, secondhand embarrassment, frustration, gay, and sadness.
I identify with all four. I guess that means I am a homestuck. How many asks do you get in a day, Puckacho?
Depends on how active I am, but usually 40 to 50, Smelly.
I'm not smelly!
You are. You've always been. You always will be. And that's okay. It's a nice smell. Goodbye.
Aliens being confused by how humans deal with scent. Human. Oh, I'm gonna have to wash this blanket to get rid of that new smell.
Okay, wash blanket, get rid of weird smell.
Gotta love that new car smell.
Okay, then cars, it's a different story, I guess. Drop that one out.
Ah, old book smells so good.
I don't know what I'm supposed to write here.
I love that new book smell.
Why are you like this?
Are there any book series that an author has finished and then continued again down the line, done a spinoff that have actually been good?
Trying to think of any where the new additions to the series weren't absolute garbage.
So,
Percy Jackson.
And Tamora Pierce are the most suggested examples here. And shout out to the person who suggested the New Testament.
Good job. Classy.
Parents picking their child's name.
I like the way it sounds, sure.
Writers picking their character's name.
What genre is it? How old are they? Active or passive blood type? Country of origin? Is it a family name? What does the name mean? Is it pretentious? Is it not pretentious enough? Can it be used as a metaphor? What position was the planet to the stars at the exact moment of their birth? Is the name gay enough?
Alternatively, writer looks around room, spots a can of Lysol on their table.
Ah, the great King Lyson, ruler of the nation of Tableria. I'm not religious, and I got bored with the default, oh my god, and Jesus Christ expletives. So now when I examine, I just use the names of my favorite historical figures. For example, Suffering Sappho.
My parents are religious, so I'm not allowed to say those. And I'm also not allowed to curse. So my three replacement words and phrases are shiznuggets, curses, and by the knees of Barry B. Benson.
By the knees of Barry B. Benson is technically in violation of the 8th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution.
But how, though?
Forbids cruel and unusual punishment. And the winner of the bake-off is
9 dismembered bodies.
This is like Cards Against Humanity. How the fuck did this happen?
You've heard of press F to pay respects. Now get ready for please press O to spend time with the boys.
You know, I've never seen a prompt in a video game that asks so politely. You know what? I think I will press O to spend time with the boys. Thank you very much, video game.
Where would we be as a society without gay podcasts?
Nowhere! That's where!